4-point lead if it involves the New York Enforcers, anybody's game.
Well, Ken, it's gut check time, and will we have a new leader of the pack or the same old New York Enforcers?
Just under 2.5 minutes remaining, time for 2, possibly 3 jams. The Quakes lead at 24-20. The Enforcers in dire straits and perhaps losing their leaders of the pack title. Blaze Leon and Eichhorn out for New York, and this is Gary Lockerbie for California. But they're 2-1 on the jam, but so far New York has not been able to take much opportunity. The right there, Leal just locking me into the railing. They trail by 4. What an opportunity as Eichhorn and Leon close on the pass, dropping back to block. It's Chad Vaughn for the California Quakes. Nails Eichhorn. Eichhorn again. Now he takes care of Leon with great blocking by Vaughn, keeping them both at bay. Now one of the Quakes is trying to catch up to Elbum. But then Ken Washington says Lockerbie right out over the railing and also on the other side. Santiago goes into the railing and suddenly California Quakes are all over the track as Eichhorn cuts off the jam.
I said minutes ago you learned to never bet against the New York Enforcers, and very quickly New York puts 8 points on the board. They go on from a 4-point deficit to a 4-point lead.
Well, they're real comfortable, all these New York Enforcers, as leaders of the pack. And Sean Atkinson is getting that firsthand. And if getting knocked down wasn't enough, and if the 8 points wasn't enough, Mark D'Amato adds insult to injury by going to the knee of Sean Atkinson. Obviously, Sean Corbin may have something to say to Mark D'Amato about the behavior right there. And Sean Atkinson, it looks like a little bit of a day. Sean Atkinson looks on. His team is in trouble, Ken.
We're under 1 minute to go, but remember, now the jam has started, it can go the full 60 seconds. The Enforcers lead at 28-24. We'll see what Captain Sean Atkinson can pull out of his bag of tricks. Right now, taking the whip is Fred Eichhorn from Brian Gamble. Eichhorn right now, the long jammer out. Remember, once the jam is gone, 30 seconds in the WSL, scoring or not, Eichhorn could cut it off. And unfortunately for the Quakes, both of the jammers, Santiago and Scopey, still at the very back of the pack, not even out yet, as Eichhorn closes in.
Well, and I'll tell you what, the eliminator by Mark D'Amato 2 jams ago set the precedent in this fourth quarter. That shows you how Mark D'Amato's physical play can impact the game.
Well, now Sean Atkinson takes down Fred Eichhorn, but unfortunately for him, you see D'Amato setting up for the eliminator. Oh, baby, Sean Atkinson goes low. He may have won the battle, but unfortunately the Quakes lose the war 28-24.
And the bus squad loves it.
A painful lesson for Mark D'Amato, who went to the well one too many times.
And the eliminator definitely went awry. And right there you see the result of what Sean Atkinson did to Mark D'Amato, as the pain on his face says it all.
Let me tell you something, we might have lost the war, but I won the battle. Sometimes you gotta give a little bit. I gave up a little bit, but I tell you what, D'Amato gave up a little bit more.
Oh, damn! What was with that last play? What happened on that last play? You outsmarted him finally.
Yeah, I'm tired of that little admiral thing he's doing. Let me tell you, it's time for a little nutcracker. Oh, damn!
All right, back to you, Ken and Hawk.
Well, I'm a little bit surprised, Hawk, the California Quakes see me late, and even though they lost the game, I guess they're taking the philosophy they may have lost the war, but Sean Atkinson certainly won the last battle.
Well, I tell you what, I think Mark D'Amato may have lost a more important war. Ouch.
At any rate, for all of us here in RollerJam Arena, Lee the Hawk Wehrman, Broadway Danny Wolf, Director Mike Miller, Producer Brian Gadinsky, I'm Ken Resnick saying have a great week. We'll see you next time. So long, everybody.